But I want to check on the team news to start with. Is everyone okay after Sevilla in midweek? I'm thinking particularly with Thiago Silva and Christian Pulisic.
Yeah, both are fine. We've got a pretty clean bill of health on that side, other than Kepa, who has a shoulder issue, so won't travel to Manchester. The only other player out is Billy Gilmore, which is obviously long term, but he'll be back soon.
So is Piatek on standby, or can he stand down this
game? Piatek's not coming on. Not in that capacity of what you're getting at.
Look, are you amazed at the coverage, his inclusion in the Premier League sport? Generated.
I suppose if you're Piatek and you've been one of the best goalkeepers, the Premier League, in my opinion, the best, but in the Premier League history in the modern era, I'm guessing it's always a big story, anything around him.
After the defensive frailties last weekend against Southampton, what has that goalless draw against Sevilla done in terms of restoring confidence at the back? And at least a way of being defensively solid, yet still attackingly creative.
Yeah, I think, listen, a clean sheet always gives confidence, and that's great, but it's a very simplistic way of looking at games is to say, that game, because you conceded, these things were all wrong, and that game, because it was a clean sheet, these things were all right. You know, my job is constantly to analyse what was good and what was bad. Some parts of our game in Seville off the ball were not as good as I wanted them to be. Our defending the box and our resilience certainly was, and that really, really pleased me. Those finer details of how we want to be off the ball, which is something I think we were really good at last year in terms of when we were set, how hard we worked to win it back, the pressure we put on teams, that wasn't where we were conceding goals. We conceded goals in other ways, which we were very aware of. So that's always going to be constantly what we're trying to work on. But the simple answer is, yeah, I'm happy with a clean sheet and we keep going.
You go to Old Trafford, Chelsea 8 points from 5 matches so far in the top half of the table. United 6 points from 4 matches there in the bottom half. They've lost both of their home league matches this season and conceded 9 goals in the process, 6 of them against Spurs. Since then, they've scored 4 against Newcastle, they've won at PSG. In some ways, are they perhaps even more unpredictable than Chelsea just?
I think the league's unpredictable. You could analyse Manchester there. We could talk about certain games where big teams have conceded a lot of goals, or there's been big turnarounds in games. We've been part of one of those. So have others. So I'm not really interested in that. And I think Manchester United are a very good team. We played them enough last year to know that. And I'm not concerned in what might have happened in games before. I take them at face value.
One more, please, Ian.
Look, we hear Manchester United are one of those clubs involved in talks about a possible European Premier League, Liverpool as well, Chelsea reportedly approached. Can I get your thoughts on that? And do you perhaps sense, given that this is coming off the back of last week's Project Big Picture, is there a sense that clubs want something different?
I don't know, and I don't want to comment on something that I've read a headline of. It's so far away from me. I don't know the detail, thinking about Manchester United. And that's not me dodging the question. I literally don't want to start giving us any form of detailed answer on something that I don't understand. Concentrated on the Premier League, concentrated on Manchester United tomorrow, simple as that.
Moose, please. Thank you. Talk Sport.
Hi, Frank, how are you?
Hi, Moose, very good, thank you.
Can I ask you, do you think your team is now beginning to come together? You've had them for 2 months. I know Ziyech's only just come into the team, but do you think that between defence and attack that they're maybe starting to just come together a bit more? Are you seeing signs of that?
I'm seeing some signs of that, but I also know that the way that we've brought 6 players in really that are looking to come and compete in our first 11, a lot of them had injuries coming in, some of them are younger as well. So, you know, I'm seeing signs, and I'm seeing signs of things I want us to improve in every game. So I'm not jumping ahead of myself. I knew this would be something which would take some time. We missed a pre-season, so our time now is real-life games, which is not always great. That's why I expect us to get better. And we need to keep working on those points, because it's not a perfect situation to have new players and you don't have training time with them. But we'll keep working.
Liverpool have got key injuries, Frank. So City have made an uncertain start. United, as you played this weekend, have been poor so far at home. Do you think the league is is more open than it has been for many a year. And with the coronavirus around, players testing positive and maybe managers not knowing who they're going to be able to have in their squad from week to plan, do you think that this season there's more of a chance for Chelsea, there's more of a chance for other clubs to challenge what were the established top two in the last couple of years?
I think there's been an uncertainty within life, actually, and then within the game, which has brought about an unpredictability, which we've seen in early stage of the season. We only have to focus on ourselves and what we possibly can do. We have belief in this squad, and as I keep referring to, it will take some time, but we have quality in this squad as well. So we'll see. You know, we'll see how things level out as the season goes on. I don't want to predict too much of what the season might look like when we're this early into a season. It's far too early to start committing to what might be different or not. Our focus has to remain on ourselves.
And finally, off the back of that, does this still feel like a really big game, Manchester United, Chelsea? You said that before the Liverpool game at home a couple of weeks ago. It feels really like a big game.
Yeah, it certainly does, Moose, and as it should do. And we played them a lot. We played them in two cup competitions as well as the league last year. They're a quality team, got quality individuals, quality organisation. You saw how they go to Paris in midweek and get a fantastic result. And as you sort of touched on, and as we all know at the minute, everything is very close in the league. Everybody is in and around themselves. You know, teams around us that would expect to be up there, we're in that level at the moment. So it's an opportunity to get some very hard-earned points, but going to be a really tough match.
Hugh Ferris, PLP.
Hi, Frank. Just on that, how important do you think, bearing in mind the inconsistencies you've spoken about, and we're kind of assuming there won't be a runaway winner, as there has been the last three years, how important will the matches between last year's top four or the so-called big six be in the final reckoning, given all the closeness that you've spoken about?
I don't know. Again, it's so early to assume anything. You can't assume that there won't be runaway winners or not or whatever. This is early knockings, and particularly when you think of the different starts that teams have had in terms of how much they've been able to work going into this season. So the games against teams around you or so-called teams around you will always be big. They're great for confidence if you can play well and get a result. And obviously on points, they obviously are great. But over the course of a season, there's a lot more to it than that. There's the points that you can grind out. Certainly last year, we were not so strong at grinding out points at home that we should have done. And that's something that would have definitely affected our league position. So we have to see it more well-rounded than that. But when you come up against a big competitor with very good players, of course, it could be great to win the game.
Okay, last two, Nick Purewall and then Jerry Cox to finish.
Hi Frank, thanks for your time as always. We spoke to Hakim Ziyech and Edouard Mendy yesterday, and Hakim was talking about, you know, he's saying never really afraid to say what he thinks, to give strong opinions. And obviously Edouard with his story of having had his year out of football, having had a difficult time. I know you've talked in the past about personality in regard to your players on the pitch and personality of your team and individuals, but is it important for them to have, you know, strong personalities as individuals in their lives as well? Does that feed into what makes a good player?
Yeah, I certainly think it does. When I look at the squad, I always want to help grow the ideas of leaders within the group, personalities within the group. Over the course of long, difficult seasons where we play so many games, there will be moments where you really rely on them to help you in tough times and also to push the good times along and try and improve every day. I don't think you can get on in elite sport, in any elite team sport, without people with personality and character in the team. And I've seen that in Hakim, and I've seen it in Edu Mendy as soon as they've come through the door. Hakim has confidence about him. His fitness is coming individually. He still needs a bit of time to get his actual match fitness now his injury is cleared up. But both of those will be great additions on that front. And I encourage personality. I encourage communication between the players. We need more of that.
Last question in the broadcast, Jerry Cox.
Hi, Frank.
Hi, Jerry.
Just following up on that, Hakim said yesterday, you know, he's still not up to full match fitness, full sort of speed. How difficult is it to integrate him when the games are coming thick and fast and obviously he's new to the league and the intensity of the Premier League?
Yeah, Jerry, it's very difficult because we have a bubble here at Cobham. We cannot play against the under-23s or bring over a lot of kids to replicate 11v11 games on big size pitches, which is where generally you'd want someone to be working when they've not played for 5 or 6 months off the back of an injury. So we missed that. We missed that. So we just have to do the best we can, train as well as we can, find the right way to give Hakim minutes and others in the squad, because you know a few of our new signings did come in with certain issues, and try and get that as quick as we can. That's been challenging.
Okay, that's the end of the broadcast. We're now going to do a daily newspaper section. So, Virgin, cameras off, please.